Right now at 5:30, the fight over an historic house has taken a nasty turn. A woman is suing Norfolk Council members, saying they hid the rezoning process of Talbot Hall from the public. We first told you about the fight to preserve Talbot Hall back in June. That's when council members allowed a developer to build 14 homes on the prime waterfront property along the Lafayette River near DePaul Medical Center. Some residents are worried about preserving the 200-year-old house still on the site. They organized a petition and gathered signatures. On Your Side's Ava Hurdle is live with the tales of this latest twist. Ava?
Well, Anita, that ODU professor is asking the court to impose a $500 fine on each council member and declare its actions invalid.
I think we need as much transparency as possible in government.
Mary Novak lives near the Talbot Hall Manor House, which City Council voted to rezone back in June. More than a dozen homes will go up on the property. But Joyce Hoffman, an ODU professor, claims in court papers that the decision came about after what she termed secret discussions. It goes on to say, quote, these illegal deliberations took place during at least two closed-door sessions. She contends this should have taken place in public.
I think the meeting should be held with the community present. I don't think that decisions that affect the public should be made in private by City Council.
But City Attorney Bernard Pishko defended the council's actions and told us by telephone in part, quote, Norfolk Council passed zoning to assure the preservation of Talbot Hall. In her legal complaint, Hoffman asked the court to declare the council's actions invalid, have the council hold a public discussion on Talbot Hall, and impose a $500 fine on each council member. Novak isn't taking sides there, but opposes the rezoning of the historic home on the Lafayette River.
I think it's a beautiful piece of property. I think it should be opened. My children grew up here and they and their friends played down there, and I think it should be open to everybody to come and enjoy the land. It's beautiful.
She just feels the development is a bad investment. Now, while the resolution of this legal issue is expected in a courtroom, no date set yet for a hearing. Live in Norfolk, Ava Hurdle, 10 on Your Side.